YouTube recently announced a brand new app called YouTube Create. The idea is anyone with a phone or possibly even a tablet, you're able to download the app and you can edit your content on there. And specifically, you get some benefits if you are specifically uploading to YouTube after you edit your content, such as being able to directly upload to YouTube right away. As a professional video editor, I wanted to give this a shot, so with me today, I have my Google Pixel Fold here. So I'm gonna try it on the big screen, I'm gonna give it a shot, kinda get a firsthand experience of what this would be like, and over time, things will probably get better, at least I really hope so. And over time as well, this will be available at some point on iOS devices, but for right now, it is only on Android, so other than that, let's just get into it because I really want to try this. Okay, with the app open, you can see on the top left there, it does say create beta. Now, I do indeed want to bring my idea to life here. So let's go ahead and start. And now I get a bunch of options there. Now, I did pre-record one clip, which you can actually see right here. It's the one with my face on it. I pre-recorded that for this editing purpose, but I think if anything, what would be better is for me to import a different project. So let me go find that really quick. All right, so now that I found it, it says right there that I can either trim or I can import. Given that this video that I'm gonna import is almost 20 minutes long, I think it would be best if I just trim it down. And I don't need to watch the whole thing. So let's just trim it down to like 5 minutes. I click import, right? All right, there you go. So I'm gonna assume that this whole importing process is just like any other video editor where it's gonna bring it in, it might it's gonna convert it, yep. So it says, because you're importing a large file, we're converting it for you to enhance your editing experience, which is actually pretty good. It's almost like, I don't know, I don't think it's gonna create proxies or anything like that, but if it is converting it for a better editing experience, then one can hope that when you export it, you'll be exporting in the fullest quality that this has to offer. So, all right, let's wait this out now. So now that I have the project open, I can see that there's definitely a lot of options down here. There is one called audio cleanup already. So you know what? Let's just assume that you want to do that right away. So I'll go ahead and click that. Okay, so now I'm going to assume that my audio is being cleaned up. So maybe like some voice isolation or something. So now I got to let that do that. Audio cleanup is turned on. Tap again to turn it off. Okay, so now let's actually... Okay, where's the trim? I see two. So there's one on the right side where my thumb would be closest, which is good. That's really good placement. That's exactly what it is, awesome. And then, oh, we got our first crash. That's all right, let's just open that again. And let's try that out again. So I'm scrolling through, oh wait, does that mean, oh no, the audio, okay, so the settings did save. Okay, I don't have to do the audio cleanup again. So are these white dots like the audio? That's exactly what it is. Okay. Sure. So where do I start talking?
As a video editor, a lot of the
Okay. So let's get a little more specific and get in there. I would trim right here. Now, I do want to change my color a little bit here. So there are some filters. So let's see if one of them can do my clip justice. Pop doesn't, it wasn't horrible, but it did help with the colors. Wow, they have a lot of options. Okay. All right, I'll go do pop, but then I'll minimize its effect because I don't need it to be as strong as I saw it there. Wait, is it even applying? I'm gonna assume it is. Let's just do 50%. But can I actually now just do it myself? Can I do, no, I don't think I've, wait, cut up. Oh, there's a lot of effects. Let's do adjust. There we go. So I can increase my brightness a bit. Nice, I can see that. I don't think if anything, the shadows can just come up ever so slightly. So the background can be seen a bit. Honestly, I'll just do that still for now. Now, also I sometimes punch in. Okay, that actually worked. Okay, so I can just click and punch in. That's pretty cool. Okay, so now that I got my colors in place, let's just continue again.
As a video editor, a lot of the
All right, let's find my actual take. It looks like it's right here.
As a professional to create their own YouTube channel.
Ah, okay. So when you cut, it just So when you cut and you delete the previous side of the clip, it doesn't actually just put the cursor where that cut was made, so you can continue. You have to like manually go back and check it yourself. It's just little things like that that add up in the editing process. So that's why that does bother me a little bit, but, you know, it's fine. Keep going.
As a professional editor, a lot of times I get asked, what software do I use?
Okay, so let's just cut here, and let's quickly do some punch-ins on certain clips for a little dynamicness, I guess.
As a professional editor, a lot of times I get asked,
right there, cut that.
What software do I use?
Okay, what software do I use? Oh, I can't punch it in now? So what do I do if I can't? Oh, now I can. So let's say I punch myself in a little bit more.
I get asked, what software do I use? What should someone use if they're interested in starting to learn editing or to create their own YouTube channel?
Okay, can I? What am I doing wrong here? Is it the cursor? Do I have to? Okay, so the cursor has to be on there for me to do these punch-ins. Okay, that's good to know.
Say, doesn't really matter. Just depends on your preference, what you like, what does one software do more than the other that you're probably gonna need for what you're trying to do. So in the end, it's gonna come down to what you need in preference.
Okay, I added some punchiness now, but now there are some effects I wanna check out. So the effects, I will assume, are going to impact the section or the clip that you have clicked. So right now,
a lot of times I get asked, what software do I use?
Right there, that clip with the punchiness. Let's see if I can add an effect to it. So,
what software do I use?
Oh, that was cool.
What software do I use?
3D glasses. Okay.
What software do I use? What software do I use?
Now, if the effect is too harsh, there isn't a way to, like, make it lower so it's not as harsh, but that's pretty neat.
What software do I use?
That, you know what, this Cell Flames one could be pretty cool for like a title card or something. I think that. We got some paper textures.
What software do I use?
Oh, it just, okay.
What software do I use?
I like the paper texture.
What software do I use?
It'd be nice if the paper texture can move a little bit, but yeah, that's some limitations there.
What software do I use? Ooh, nope.
What is this?
What software do I use? What software do I use? What software do I use?
There we go. Teal and Orange. That's what I'm talking about. So Teal and Orange has this like grit with it. Like that moving texture look.
What software
look?
Do I use?
That's cool. That's another cool title card type of feel. All right, let's just use the Cell Flames.
What software?
You know what I should do because of this cool little flame thing that I like? What if I just add a text of the quote that I just said? So text, I do see plain text and then text effects. So let's do, what's text effects? What do you guys have? Okay, but do some of these move? Is there a way I can preview that? Probably not because that'll take more CPU or GPU power, but I think it would be cool. Wow, they actually have a lot of good options. The only question is, do these animate? Do these just pop up like this? Or all right, let's just pick this. It looks simple, but it looks more like a movie thing. All right, whatever. What should I use? Question mark. Okay. Can I make it smaller? Yes, I can. Wonderful. Given the way it is, it looks like it's being written. It'll be on the left. Okay. And then now, I need to see more of my timeline. There we go. Dang. Okay. I don't like that. Like right where my title is, it's being cut off by the number top, the section where the numbers are for like the seconds. It'd be nice if I could adjust that so I can see more of my timeline, especially with editing. That's such a big thing for me. All right, let me see. Hold on. All right, let's play that back.
Editor, a lot of times I get asked, what software do I use? What should someone...
Oh, that's cool. So it does animate. Is it time-based? If I extend this, will the animation change based on the time?
Ask, what software do I use? What should someone use if they're interested in starting...
Okay, so it repeats. Okay, that's fine. That's still not bad. Okay, I like that. All right, for that little section, I'll add one more effect. It doesn't really matter. Because in reality, again, it
doesn't really matter. Doesn't really matter.
All right, I'll try that teal and orange one because I do like that. And then let's do, let's add some text as well. So text effects, it doesn't really matter. So that one looks like it would fit. Actually, it does look like it would fit. It doesn't really matter. done. Change the size here. What if I keep it at an angle for a little, a bad boy aesthetic to make it match this grit? And then we line it up. Okay, almost done here.
Say.
All right, let's play this back then really quick.
I say. Doesn't really matter. Just depends on your...
I mean, I went by really quick, but you get the idea.
Say. It doesn't really matter.
Okay, the last thing I'm going to do now is import a photo that I already created. It should be on my phone because I'm going to see what effects I can have for like photos or icons or anything that you want to throw on screen because you utilize that kind of stuff like in B-roll. So let's give that a shot. So now that I have the icon in there, what I want to do is just place it on the top left there. And then I want it maybe a little more down like that. And then I want it to animate in. So I see this animation button. Yeah, let's try these out. Oh, good. I can actually see the preview. Yes, that's what I'm talking about. And you can adjust the timing for that. Oh, that was cool. I'll try that one.
Where do I use? What should someone use if they're interested in starting to learn editing or... to create their own YouTube channel?
I do notice, though, that with the animation, it is confined. You can see the box that is being created, right, around the icon itself. So it's using the aspect ratio or the box in which I created this icon instead of just keeping it and knowing that it's like it has transparency in the background. And it's just one of those things that, like, this is good to learn if you're going to create something custom, that the software reads the borders of it. Okay, that's good to know. Okay, so now I want to animate it out. So let's do one more animation. And for finish, we'll do...
YouTube channel.
We'll do that. Okay, so I dabbled in some effects. I put in a photo, did some transitions, put some text on screen. So let's go ahead and give this a playback and see how it looks.
As a professional editor, a lot of times I get asked, what software do I use? What should someone use if they're interested in starting to learn editing or to create their own YouTube channel? And more often than not, I say, doesn't really matter. Just depends on your preference, what you like.
All right, so now that we have a little bit of this stuff, I do want to say this. Now I'm going to export the video. And what I forgot to mention earlier is the fact that this video that I recorded was shot in 4K. So I was editing 4K footage on here, and this did indeed enhance it for a better editing experience, like they said. But now my concern is when I export, I want to make sure that I get it in the 4K quality that I did record it in. So let's give this a shot. So let's see, where would the export button be? Probably up there, yeah. Oh, you can even choose your own aspect ratio. 9x16 or 1x1. Oh, that's good. 1x1. That's good for like Twitter and stuff, or Instagram, 9x16, Twitter as well, and Instagram as well for shorts. And okay, not bad. I like that. Now, let's still export though. Okay, quality. Huh. So this is only letting me export in either 1080p or standard 720p. So that's okay, that's not bad given the fact that a lot of times we don't need 4K footage, but the fact that I did shoot it in 4K, I would like to keep it in the resolution that I shot it in. But let's give this a shot at 1080p. Let's go ahead and export. All right, and now it's doing its thing. Okay, so it says now, ready to watch, your video is downloaded to this phone so you can upload or share it now. And right there, it goes back to the benefit that I mentioned where you can directly upload to YouTube. I do think that's cool, especially if you just want to get it out the way, because this does link to your channel if you sign in with it. But me being me, I just want to preview it right now. I don't want to upload anything yet, so I'm going to go ahead and exit, and I'm going to go and find the video. It says it's saved on my phone, so let's see where it's at. Okay, I found my video in my videos folder in the phone itself. I use File Manager to find it, so let's go ahead and quickly preview this, and let's see how it came out.
As a professional editor, a lot of times I get asked, what software do I use? What should someone use if they're interested in starting to learn editing or to create their own YouTube channel? And more often than not, I say, What does one software do more than the other that you're probably gonna need for what you're trying to do? So in the end, it's gonna come down to what you need in preference.
So to get my final thoughts here, I actually really like so far how the app is looking. I didn't try every feature because it didn't come out naturally in the editing for the video that I had with me, but this is something I definitely want to revisit. So for you watching the video, if there was anything that you gained from this, let me know down below. And let me also know if there's anything you want me to try that you want to see, or just how I would creatively approach a project on the phone device itself. I definitely want to record something with the intention of using more of the features. But for now, I think for a first-hand experience, I kind of liked it. It wasn't that bad. I do still prefer editing on a computer, though. Don't think I'm gonna leave my computer now for this. Computer, still king. But leave any questions down below in the comment section and feel free to follow me on X or Twitter, whatever you wanna call it. It's the only social media site that I am pretty much active in. And then also, if you'd like the editing for my video, feel free to email me and my business email down below and contact me. If I have any availability, I do like to take freelance work. But if not, watch my next video when it comes out. Thank you for watching.